Hello, Mrs. Stevens here. We just looked at the four categories of gross domestic product: consumption, investment, net exports, and government expenditures. Now we're going to take a look at the Bureau of Economic Analysis, the government agency that employs many, many number crunchers who are gathering data to try to calculate the gross domestic product every quarter. So, looking at the header here, you can see Bureau of Economic Analysis, BEA.gov. And I like this table here because it shows you the gross domestic product in terms of the actual dollars. So, we can see the real dollar amounts. In the news, you hear gross domestic product referred to as did it increase or decrease? From one quarter to the next, what was the percent increase, the percent decrease? You never hear anybody talk about how much was it, but this is important to look at this because it really gives you a flavor for how much we produce as a nation, as an economy. So the first line is the line seven, the gross private domestic investment. That's the total gross domestic product. And I'm sorry, let's move up. Here we go, line one, gross domestic product for the first quarter of 2012 is 15,381 billion. These numbers are expressed here in billions of dollars. Okay, so that's our total. The next line is personal consumption expenditures, which is consumption. This is consumer spending, and look at this number here. It's roughly a little over $10 trillion, which is about two-thirds of the total gross domestic product. So you see, consumers really drive the economy, and it's broken down between, first of all, between goods and services, and then within the goods category, we have durable goods, which are items that have a life of 2 years or more, and then we have non-durable goods, which are things like food and energy. The next category is gross private domestic investment, which is business spending. This is a much smaller number as a percent or as a portion of the gross domestic product, but it's still very important. And this category here is broken down between fixed, well, really, there's just one category, fixed investment. There's also change in private inventories, which is a small, it's kind of an adjustment number. So we're going to ignore that one for the moment. So within the fixed investment category, we have non-residential and residential. Under non-residential, we have structures, that's buildings, apartment buildings. And we have equipment, which is equipment, machinery, vehicles, fleets, boats, trains, just all kinds of equipment that you can think of. And then we have a new category here. This is new this year, intellectual property products. So that's things like mobile apps, computer programs, and even pharmaceutical patents and patents on other inventions. Copyrights, all of those, and all of that intellectual property. And then the residential category. So all houses are included in investment spending. So the house that you live in was actually included in the GDP in the investment section in the year that it was built. The next category is net exports of goods and services. So first we have exports. These are products that were produced here or services that were came from here, but were consumed somewhere outside the United States. So because they haven't been counted anywhere yet, because so far we've counted the consumption of consumers and the consumption of businesses. So this consumption occurred outside the United States. Now we're going to add this in. We have goods and services that came from the United States that were produced here, so we're going to add those in. Imports, on the other hand, if you think of going to Walmart, taking a look at all of the merchandise in your shopping cart, how much of that has a tag that says it was produced somewhere outside the United States. So you're buying those things. Consumers are purchasing merchandise at Walmart and other places. So that number is included in the consumption section of GDP. We want to remove that because that represents products that were not produced here. And again, it's broken down into goods and services. And the last category is government consumption expenditures and gross investments. That's government expenditures for short, broken down between federal spending and state spending. Federal spending broken down between national defense and non-defense. So you can see how much of government spending is made up of defense spending. It's a pretty good portion. And the other interesting thing to notice about government expenditures is if you look at federal expenditures, look at the trend over time. So the first column is first quarter 2012. And so 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is the first quarter of 2014. So by the looks of it, it has, for the most part, the general trend has been a downward trend. So there's been a lot of concern in the news, on cable news and different places like that, about government spending. And lo and behold, government spending is decreasing. Kind of interesting. State and local spending, it's kind of holding steady here, it looks like. But look at this, it's a larger portion of government spending than the federal spending. And then the last portion here, this is just kind of a correction. It's an adjustment residual. This is an adjustment. So that's the gross domestic product on the BEA.gov website.